నేను ఒక స్టార్
హలో గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఐ ఆమ్ ఏ గణపతి ఐఎమ్ రిపోర్టింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎలక్ట్రో ప్రో ఇండియా ఐ ఆమ్ ఏ రీసెర్చ్ ఇంజనీర్ అట్ ఎలక్ట్రో ప్రో ఇండియా నౌ సంథింగ్ అబౌట్ ఎలక్ట్రో ప్రో ఎలక్ట్రో ప్రో యాజ్ యూ కెన్ సీ ఇన్ ద స్లైడ్స్ వి ఇన్ కంట్రీస్ మే నాట్ ఎక్స్చేంజ్ కల్చర్ బట్ వీ మే ఎక్స్చేంజ్ టెక్నాలజీ త్రూ ఎలక్ట్రో ప్రో సో ఇన్ ద స్లైడ్ వీ వాంట్ ఎవ్రీ వన్ టు ఎంజాయ్ ద బెనిఫిట్స్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ టెక్నాలజీ irrespective of their cultures before our technology expands. So now our today's aim, so why we have I have all gathered you here, we have all gathered you here to teach something about that is known as STEM. As you can see, this slide says STEM. S stands for science, T for technology, P for engineering, M for mathematics. So now this, why do we learn STEM technologies? STEM technology concepts are used to create logical thinking and create mental ability among students. Using these concepts, we are able to crack entrance exams and become more future successful. Taking an example regarding the STEM concept. So I take an example of LED. In the case of LED, the material used in its making is known as the science. The light of LED is a technology, and the device used in engineering. Speed calculation of light is mathematics. So why we have told you about STEM? We have told you about STEM because we will be teaching you now regarding robotics. So coming to the application programming, what is technology? So as you know, in your school there is a science teacher who teaches you science subject. In engineering, there are various engineering subjects who teach along with engineering, and there is a mathematics teacher. So now what about technology? So now we have come here to teach you something about technology, and in that we would be covering you regarding robotics. So now we come to the next slide. It says, when the name comes the robot to your mind, you may see different pictures. As you see in the slide, this may be a picture, this may be a picture, or maybe this, or maybe this. So what do you mean by the definition of a robot? A robot is basically a machine designed to execute one or more tasks repeatedly with speed and precision. So now I am saying you something about robotics. So now how to create a robot? First we need some basic concepts that are as sense, plan and act. Going to the details, sense means you should sense something that it is going to happen or it will be happening. After the sense is designed, so we will be designing a plan according to the senses given. After the plan is over, we will be acting according to the plan provided to us. So now we come to my first robot. So say, as the name says, my first robot, we will be creating a robot according to our will. The first step to create is we will be visualizing our own robot and figure. So I'll draw a diagram on a note such that, as I say, I want my robot to be like a human or animal. So you can say that your robot can be anything. After that, name your name as a robot. I gave my name to robot, that is, my name is Ganesh robot. After that, after giving and drawing, say some purposes of your robot. I say that I want my name and draw it, and I will be waiting for you. Now, as you have all completed, now let's see, what does your robot do? Or which type of robot is it? So I tell you that I will be you come, which robot is it? So as you say, if your robot works only for the home purposes, it can be known as the home kind of robot. If the robot works for you, so it can be told as the personal assistant robot. If my robot has been designed to do all the service related works, I call it a service related robot. And if my robot comes and greets guests and socializes with them, it can be told as a socialized robot. Now coming to the next, how many different types of robot? The humanoid robot, it is basically the robot that you have designed so far by a little bit of idea. The pick and place robot, as in the name says, these are used basically in industries. Why? To pick and place things. And now coming to the most easily made robot, that is the two-wheeler robot. Now two-wheeler robot, what is a two-wheeler robot? Basically, two-wheeler robots are the robots that are designed easily with this component. The components are, they have two wheels, two motors, a couple of wires, a controlling unit, a design case, a couple of screws to be bolted, a free wheel and a battery. Using all these components, we design a two-wheeler robot. What is the basic use of two-wheeler robot? As you see, the two-wheeler robot is used basically to move forward and backward. Now, I say something about what are sensors. So, sensors are something that are used to sense some object or movement. So, in the previous, as I told you, there is a two-wheeler robot. Using these sensors, we are able to design many different types of robot. As you see, there are different types of sensors. Human detection robot can be designed only using a human detection sensor. An obstacle robot can be designed using obstacle sensors. A line follow robot can be using a light detecting sensor. Now, coming, we will be discussing everything in detail. So now I say about a human detection robot. As a two-wheeler robot, we only add a human detection sensor. What is a human detection sensor? It is basically a sensor that is added in a presence of two-wheeler robot to detect if a human comes in front of a robot. As if it detects is there any human, then it will be stopping automatically as sensed or signaled by the given sensor. So as you see, now we are going to an obstacle robot. Obstacle robot is also an additional feature in which we are adding the obstacle based sensor to the given two-wheeler robot. All the components are basically same. The most important is an obstacle detector sensor. As soon as the obstacle is detected, it will be sensed by the sensor and it will be signaled to the robot. So after the signal is provided, it will be stopping there as soon as possible. Now come to the next, the light detecting sensor. Now in this sensor, as you see, the two-wheeler robot is also present. We add a new feature, that is the light detector. As the light detector senses the signal or the light, now it will be saying, as soon as the light goes, it will be following the similar light and it will be going in the same way. Coming to the next, it is a bomb detecting robot. As a two-wheeler, we have given two wheels, motors, along all the components, we add a most important sensor, that is the metal detection sensor. As the sensor detects, there is if any presence of metal coming in between or against the robot, so it will be sensing and giving a signal. So as soon as the signal is sent to the robot, it will be designed and moved according to the code given. So thank you. We have covered different types of robots so far. So now if you want to create a different type of robot as per your family members, so you add different type of sensors. For adding different type of sensors or creating robotics or the different type of robot, you can go through our robotics program, and for the demo you can move to the other class.